Hi, everyone. And I will introduce myself first and our speakers, discussant, and director of the film. My name is Nurdan Atalan Çayırezmez. I am the Digital Repository Manager at BIA. Today, we are going to talk with Ahmet Emre Yaprak, as a discussant, and Professor Dr. Necmi Aksoy and Mehmet Ceyhan as a film director. Yesterday and today we had a nice workshop here about digital herbariums in Turkey, and this was the lecture after this workshop. We have thank you for speakers, discussant, and Mehmet Ceyhan. There will be 10-minute documentary screening at the end of the talk. And director Mehmet Ceyhan will join us online like today. Please feel free to introduce yourself on the chat and let us know where you are joining us for today's event. You can ask your question using the Q&A function, and we will get to them at the end of the talk. We remind you that the lecture is being recorded and live streamed on YouTube as well. So thank you very much, Necmi Aksoy. He is a professor in Düzce University, Department of Forest Botany. His main research interests are dendrology, herbaria, arboreta, and botanical gardens, invasive plant species, plant systematics, and sociology. He is the creator of the Düzce University Herbarium, DUOF, we call, and the director of the Düzce University Ornamental and Medicinal Plants Research, Production and Applications Center, which were established to preserve the plant biodiversity in the West Black Sea region of Turkey. He is one of the contributors to the Illustrated Flora of Turkey project with his work on woody taxa in Turkey. He is a member of several environmental and botanical foundations, such as Cultural Awareness Foundation, Royal Forestry Society, TEMA, and East Alpine Dinaric Vegetation Society. He has been working as the project consultant at the BIA for Herbarium Digitalization Project since January 2021. So we are very much looking forward to hearing this evening's talk titled Discovered and Going Extinct, the Effects of Human Activity on Turkey's Plant Biodiversity. So I will introduce Ahmet Emre Yaprak, who is a professor of biology at Ankara University Faculty of Science. His main research interests are systematic of seed plants, phylogeography, plant molecular systematics, and salt-tolerant plants. He has worked as an advisory board member to Hubiyom and as the assistant editor-in-chief to Herbarium Turkicum Journal. He was a research specialist in the strengthening the National Nature Protection System for the implementation of Nature 2000. Requirements project, which was concluded in 2019. Since 2020, he is the managing editor of the Communications Faculty of Sciences, Ankara University Journal. And last, but not least, Mehmet Ceyhan, who is director of the film and lecturer at Faculty of Art in Düzce University, is with us today. Necmi Aksoy is with us, and we had a problem with internet, so I will just give my seat to Necmi now. Thank you very much.
Dear audience and dear participants, I am so honored to be here for the after the hardly big intensive meeting about the digital herbarium that is organized by the BIA. At the moment, I will present it about my presentation. About the effects of human activity on Turkey's plant biodiversity. That's called that director of Mehmet Ceylan documentary, short documentary about the discovered and going extinct under the, we will present about the huge monumental biodiversity of Turkey, I would like to present it. And this biodiversity, as you know, that Turkey is among the richest countries in the world in terms of flora and vegetation diversity. The main reasons for this wealth are as follows: variety of climate, and then topographical diversity with much change in ecological and geographical variation. As you know, that Turkey is meeting ground of three big physiographical regions: north side of Eurasiberian, southern and western side of Mediterranean, and inner and eastern region is the Mediterranean region. So that this field can usually be readily recognized by their different vegetational aspects, reflecting differences in climate, but they are more fundamentally, if less obviously, based on forest differences, including endemism. There are a number of monovegetation types in these geographic regions, as forests, maquis, garrig, steppe, and alpine vegetation. Forests, maquis, garrig, and some part of the alpine and steppe vegetation spread in forest area of Turkey. As you know, that the Turkey is the transition region of the land bridge of the between Europe and Asia. If you focus on the world flora region, Turkey is found of the Paratic region, so that is over 34% of the 12 planted taxa common to Turkey are endemic. If you focus on the world biome, Turkey is in the between north side of the Eurasiberian climate, especially boreal, under the boreal and boreal and broadleaf forests, and under the Mediterranean. So it's if we focus on the mainly Mediterranean flora region, is included and distributed in Turkey. So Turkey has been many source of plant resource, such as agriculture, horticulture, medicinal, ornamental, and the woody forest and crop plants. So that if you focus on the Turkey climate, Turkey is under the oceanic climate, vegetation and climate climate effects. This is very unique map of the Turkey. It's the mainly fundamental flora's editors, Peter Hetland Davis. He's prepared this ecological regions in the flora of Turkey, first volume of one. You can see the Turkey's north side of Eurasian flora. And it's such as is different in the Kolchak and Öksin subregion. Western side of Mediterranean flora, western Aegean region. Southern is Mediterranean Taurus section. And others is a very unique climate richness is the Anatolian. And Iran Turan is separated three regions: center of Central Anatolia, Eastern Anatolia, and Mesopotamia. And you can see the very different is the last glacial period. Many Eurasiberian flora elements is migrated from the Taurus mountain. If you go to the Amanos mountain, you can see the beach and some hornbeam, Carpinus, Fagus orientalis, Buxus, boxwood, also taxus, yew trees. You can see the Amanos range, and others is some. You can see the some enclaves in this flora. For example, you can see the Yeşilırmak Valley. You can see the cedar forest, and if you can see the Inner Anatolia, Scots pine it's distributed from here, Kayseri, Pınarbaşı, and also you can see the Betula Pendula from here. Also, you can see the high alpine forest area from the Pass of Kars is a Scospine in here. Also, you can go to North Iraq, also Zapsu Valley, you can see the Calabrian pine, Pinus brutea forest. Also, maybe you can ask me, what is mean X from here? X very unique in Central Track region. It has been connected from the Danube flora region, in from the Danube River. It's Carpathian and Hungarian European steppe, dry steppeland grassland is connection from the Turkey. You can see like a very huge Turkish carpet, colorful, very beautiful floratic diversity in Turkey. What is this? This is the mountain range. Turkey is the mainly mountainic high altitudes countries. You can see the north side is the northern Black Sea mountains, southern, western, and eastern Taurus, and it's a like a vertical line. It is in the agency. You can see the Mini River is a very huge mountains, and also some is a, we call that is a dead volcanoes. I have not built that to any volcanoes is dead and or sleeping, and after that you can see the many huge volcanic mountains in Turkey. But it's give a very different climate conditions. For example, northeastern Anatolia is annual per millimeter is more than 3,000, like a tropical. So the tea plantation is growing from is Camellia sinensis from here. And also is a, you know, Anatolia is a, like a dry like a desert climate affected from the central Anatolia. So we can, it's reflected, is mountainic and pedogeographical is as adding to climate condition is give the very different vegetation types in Turkey. I always explain to Turkey is two big M is north and cross section is meeting. So that northern area Black Sea is cloudy, and after behind of the northern mountains is a rainy shadow area and isolated in Anatolia. And after that, behind of the Taurus mountain is a rainy shadow, and after that Mediterranean is a cloud and rainfall. This is a very, very important differences of the northern and southern Anatolian cross section. So what is the origin of the plant diversity? I think that is so easy to explain. It's a last glacial period. Last glacial period, after melting the ice from the Europe and northern region, many plants, especially Mediterranean plants, it's migrated from the Black Sea. If after the global warming, many Black Sea region plants is getting more Mediterranean effect. So that we can see some Mediterranean plants distribution from the Black Sea coastline, such as Laurus nobilaura trees. So you can see the many Mediterranean diverse the Mediterranean plants is affected from the this region. So you can see the Turkish altitude mainly is dark and places is a parallel lined area is a more than 1,000 high altitude. Other is a plain area under the 1,000 meters. So as I told you before, this Turkey is a mountainic ecosystem topography. So why is this origin? This is origin is the very ancient time. This is a early Mesozoic formation. Tethys Lake is after that North and South Anatolian Fault is spread after under the sea. This is the another volcanic effect is reflected of the Anatolian peninsula is rising, and after that, this volcano is Erciyes Ağrı, Hasan Dağı. It's affected to this rising from the last geological period. And if you go to the North and South Anatolian cross section, you can see the Maquis, Lower Mediterranean Belt, Red Pine Forest, Oro Mediterranean Conifer Forest is a cedar and Taurus Mountain fir trees, Abies silicica. And if you go to Inner Anatolia, high altitude mountain grass belt, and other is a subhumid forest as like oaks and others. And Inner Anatolia is a steppe. If you go to the north side, North Anatolian alpine plains, and after cold humid conifer forests, like northeastern is a oriental spruce and Normandian fir trees. If western go to the Trojan fir and Scots pine, and then Oriental beach in underground is approximately lowland of the northern slope was 1000 meters below. It's included from the beech, chestnut, hornbeam, hopobonbeam trees is a mixed, and north side is included from the pseudo maquis. So you can see the northeastern blocks is some shadowy and foggy, and is changing from the very differences of the climate conditions. So Turkey is give the very rich plant diversity, especially, and you can see the dark line is each area is 30% of the endemic plants distribution from this map. So what is the, our reserve of the rich floras is the monumental floras of the Peter Hetland Davis edited is a 10 volume flora of Turkey and the East Aegean islands. And after that, Turkish botanist is edited from the volume 11. After that, this according to the flora of Turkey, plants approximately, if you alien agriculture, approximately 11,000 taxa. After that, the Turkish botanist is published of the checklist of the flora of Turkey. It's and after recent new recorded adding many invasive alien, also new genera is the cultivated taxa alien. The number of taxa occurring in the flora of Turkey rises 11,707 taxa. Its distribution of the Turkey is also is equaling to near of the all of the European floras. So you can see the which endemic of the Peter Davis Headlands grid system in Turkey. So you can focus on approximately Mediterranean region, and Eastern Anatolia is the mainly rich endemism center of the Turkey. So you can see the endemic taxa and totally taxa from here. But at the moment, many exotic alien species is including the this flora list. So after that, Turkish botanist, planned the 28 volumes, the project of the illustrated flora of Turkey. At the moment, 2 volumes is published. So if you focus on the rich diversity, we must of the world palearctic ecoregion of the world flora, in mainly Turkey, temperate broadleaf and mixed forests is northern, temperate conifer forests, northern and central Anatolian, grasslands, savans, shrublands, and Mediterranean is mainly, is main four, and if sub ecoregion, I think that 10 ecoregion is important for the Turkey. This is of the Lake of Swift, is a polar region. It's 300 years ago, it's fault affected and crossing the lake and river stream. And after that, many dead woody plants, especially Scots pine, included of the this lake is a very unique ecosystem in Western Black Sea region. Such as very beautiful Paeonia muscula is distribution in this region. And if you go to the northern, northeastern Black Sea, is a 4 highest peak of the Turkey, the Kaçkar Mountain, 3,932 altitude. Is a this is the last glacial in the northern Black Sea, northeastern Black Sea region in the Turkey. Turkey has the 4 or 5 glacial mountain. But step by step, every year, this glacial is getting melting for the global warming. And if you go to this mountain, you can see the glacial lakes, its altitude 3,000 or 3,500 meters is a very rich glacial lakes of the this area. So you can see the very unique forest. This is the Jamali Biosphere Reserve. It's closed off the Georgian boundary. You can see the very richness, rhododendron and oriental cypress, P. orientalis, and Normandian fir, obvious Normandiana, and oriental beech mixed forest from the here. And very good, and is a, I know that is rhododendron is beautiful, but this is a very poisonous rhododendron, rhododendron luteum, yellow flower rhododendron. It's distribution from this region. And this is the Western Black Sea, is a Düzce, my working and living cities, is a mixed forest, especially oriental beech forest is a very productive and very unique mixed forest is found this region. And this is a very good, is a unique plant for Turkey, is a we call that shalba in Turkish, and then English is a Jerusalem sage. It's a very gardening plants from the Europe, especially England and then Germany as an ornamental, but Turkish is an endemic species. And then Olympus fir, this is Olympus mountain, we call that Uluda. This is obvious Normandian sub-equatorian, but synonym name is obvious Bormilleriana, unique conifer forest in the Turkey. And you can see the Uludağ is Marmara region. It's so close to Istanbul. This is highest peak of the Marmara region, 2,600 meters. Also, it's included of the one of the glacial lake in this region. This is a alpine. This is a Juniperus communis saxatilis. It's a spreading juniper. It's a prostate habit form and Bormular, also triumphal, and then Scots pine is distribution from the Alpine region. And this is Düzce, Elmacık Mountains. Is like a landscape is Europe or Scotland's, because this is Scots Pine, Pinus sylvestris. It's very closed off the western range of the Scots Pine distribution of the Black Sea region. And this is very unique. Is the category is endemic, is a vulnerable, is so sensitive. Is the we call that Turkish nazende. Nazende is a fragile, is meaning. This is a Laterus undulatus. And mainly is a Marmara region. That's called that Istanbul nazendesi. Especially is unique for the Istanbul region. And this is near of the Seven Lakes National Parks. Is a very unique, very so sensitive. So national parks of the Turkeys, especially autumn color, because it's you can see the very colorful. It's more than like a natural arboretum. It's more than 100 woody taxa is distributed from the here. You can see beech and hornbeam, raven, service trees, cherry trees, ash trees, lime trees, linden trees. It's mixed and elders is mixed from the this national park. It is so important because this is a so unique yew tree stand. It's many people is not believe is Turkey is a yew tree stands is distribution. This is Emre Yaprak, because Emre Yaprak is hometown region, is a Zonguldak Alaplı. This is old growth forest ecological. Mainly yew trees age more than 1000 years old. So it is so important, because only Black Sea region, just only one old growth yew forest is a Georgia, another is Turkey. I think that if we compare the where is the yew trees, is the ancient yew trees in the Europe, just only one is Scotland and Britain, and others is the Georgia, and others is the Turkey. Is a very unique also the symbol of the many folkloric and mythological trees, European culture, also ancient Anatolian cultures. Is many people believe that the Amazon women, they use of the dale balls and the shoots of the yew trees branch. So it is very unique ecosystem. And after that, we jump off the inner Anatolia. You can see the dry. And after that, Erciyes Mountain is rising. So it is the center of the crop, especially wheat center of the turkeys. You can see the wheat grove and other side of the another of that volcanoes, Erciyes volcano. And some is a Stachys lavandulu folia. This is very unique and endemic species from this region. And also is a World Heritage Monument of the National Monument of the Cappadocia. Cappadocica is we call that. Is this is you can see the Urgüp and Göreme. And this inner Anatolia, many river side of stream side of the plain, very unique plants growing local agricultural system. This is so close of the Ankara. This is the Nallıhan. We call that Çeltik Dere. Çeltik is means of the rice in Turkish name, and it's you can see the rice harvesting from the traditional system. So this is it must be this riverside traditional agricultural traditional plant cultures heritage is reflected from the this riverside area very close to Ankara. And this is a bird sanctuary of the, we call that Nalıhan bird sanctuary. It's a very huge geological diversity of the mineral and also very rich of the salt tolerated plants of the Emre Yaprak work about the here from many difference of the canapots distributing from the this area. And after that, we call that very strange endemic plants. It is Propria bracteata. These plants, yellow flowered, but its bracts is purple. It's so very close the transition, the steppe area of the Bolu region. This is unique endemic geophyte. And it's a very beautiful place. It's Mount Ararat, dreaming mount. It's a, you know that Noah Ark is from after the big floods, and Noah Ark is settled here, and the world is created from here. Also, if somebody is see that Mount Ararat is affected the his passion and then very huge endemic plants center, especially in the between small Ararat and big Ararat mountains, has a very rich birch and poplar forest is a very, and also is a, this verbascum is a purple Viedamannium. This is a purple flowered verbascum is distribution of the this area. And you can see this is Ardahan, and the behind of the dry grassland region in Kafkasya is like a one of the boundaries sharply is cutting is separated Caucasus mountains and northeastern mountains is a transition of the many different plants from here. And other Lake of Van, this is the third highest peak of the Turkish Pan, you can see. And this is Nemrut Crater Lake. This is this crater lake is very strange because some part of hot spring, some part of is a cold spring ecosystem. If you go to the closely area, you can see the some shrubby like trees. One of Populus tremula, one of the birch tree, Betula pendula, is natively spreading from the crateric basin. And if we jump to Mediterranean region, is like a Bergama Kozak high plateau, is a unique for the stone pine, or we call that umbrella pine, Pinus pinea forest. It's very unique. It's come from the ancient civilization, Roman period, also Bergama. Bergama is called that maybe the city of Bergama, but Bergama imperial civilization is local before the Roman period, is a small country civilization in Turkey. They producing from the ancient time, Roman and Bergama period. It's seeds is important for the woody and forest products for the Turkey. And some orchids from distribution from the Helimodum abortivum in this area. And this is very strange endemic Campanula from the Efes ruins is spreading from the Campo Tomentosa, Efes ruins, walls, and some orchids from the Aegean region. And this is very strange area. This is the Maki unique distribution from the very close the Istanbul area. This is the Kocaeli region. And it has got a very unique, sensitive, not endemic, but rare plants is distribution, such as Verbascum bugulifolia. This is so important. Many travelers, many famous botanical and travelers, the Joseph Piton Tournefort is the first time he determined and interested in these plants from the Istanbul region. If we go to the again Mediterranean area, very unique cypress forest, Cupressus sempervirens, is distribution from the Köprülü Kanyon National Parks. It is the unique of the, because we call that Italian cypress, we call that Mediterranean cypress, but mainly English name is Italian cypress, but this is more than native distribution from the Italy, north of Italy, and also National Park in Turkey. And the symbol of the Lebanon flag, and but it's important for the Turkey, we call that Cedrus Libani, we call that Katran trees, and also cedar tree is a very important for the Turkish history and folkloric trees, Turkish in Turkish history. And this is Termessos National Park, 3,100 meters altitude within the Çulukara Cedar Forest. And is we call that Turkish ginkgo, Liquidambar orientalis. It comes from the tertiary, relict, and endemic. Endemic for the Turkey and some eastern Aegean islands. Some is a small from the Rhodos Islands distribution. Why is the important? In the world has the four Liquidambar species, tree species, but only one Liquidambar trees that is using from the gum. That's called that English name, seed gum trees. This is using for the many ethnobotanical, for example, stomach effect, and some this gum using from the perfume industry. Then this oil products, product by the ancient Carian people and transport from the Egypt, for this is using the mummy and perfume industry. So it is very unique and ancient tree. So Turkey is a very important hotspot of the Global 2000 area. Some is a very important regions, Global 200 plant diversity centers is included in Turkey. So which region is important? This is firstly, Kolchak region is important because Kolchak regions is important for the relict, many relict plants. For example, Oriental cypress is a relict and endemic for the Kolchak floras. So it's a very rich and so sensitive ecologic region of the world. But it has got many different traits. Forest clearing for full wood, illegal hunting, plant collecting as a serious traits still in this ecosystem, not only Turkey, but also Georgia, Russia, Armenia, and Northern Iran and Azerbaijan. Is this still this is threatened? And then is a Mediterranean forest. Mediterranean ecosystem is very, very important. If focus on the all of the Mediterranean basin, it's like a is it Spain and go then Algeria, this side. This side is included of the 25,000 plants, is a half on endemic for the Mediterranean basin. So it is especially shrubland, maquis-like plants. This is maquis is a, so important. Only 5 ecoregion in the world is like a Mediterranean, is included as a Mediterranean. Is a California, Chile's, Cape regions, and southeastern Australia is endemic. So you can see the problem of the Mediterranean region is tourism and agriculture. They are destroyer of the many ecosystem, especially separated of the divided of the ecosystem is a small piece of like a patch, but it's not is a ecologically is separated, so it's a destroying to this area. And others is a eastern Iran Mediterranean flora region. This is approximately Turkey is like 1,200 endemic species is in the flora regions. So this is threatened for the agriculture and clear cutting for the forest and soil erosion is a big problem of this region. If you focus on the world, the expected rare and threatened plants of the world, all of the United States floras, 10,000 percentage is threatened. Europe, 17. In Turkey, is 12. Is risk. It has the risk of the threatened. If you focus on the last red data book, we can see the 12 plants is endemic, 171 critical, endangered 774, vulnerable is close to 700. So if you focus on many Turkish endemic plants is has a risk. At the moment, new work about these threatened categories updated in Turkey. Also, Emre is a member of this project. I hope that this is updating, which is high risk or not. We will clarify the next future because this publication is a very old publication. So, what is this threatened? First, clearing grounds of our fields, overgrazings and reform of barren lands, construction of dams and mining, industrialization and urbanization, especially Istanbul. Istanbul is just only Istanbul, 500 kilometers squares is a native land. Can you imagine? This is very so unique area. Habitat is a like a island. Another is a urbanizations. This is it's not enough for the living and breathing in Istanbul. Exploration, domestic use, plant production, pollutions, tourism, forestation, forest fires is the highly affected after Turkey. So what will you do for protections is the Turkey? I think that we must more work research in the above to endemic plants. Maybe we countrywide conservation policy concerning the ending plants. Another is we must be protected area, conserved area declared. And maybe we can incite the conservation like a natural reserve, micro reserve should be developed to conserve endemic plants. Maybe we can do excited conservation, should be established endemic plants, maybe botanical gardens and arboretums like that. Maybe just not only government, private sector, like institutes, like universities, it must be supported for the all of the project for the protection for the endemic and rare plants for Turkey. So, as I told you, more botanical gardens and also their connection, their network should be established. Seed banks, more seed banks, especially special groups. And maybe in Turkey, member of the European Union is just a dream. Maybe we can accept it of the their habitat types according to Natura 2000. Maybe we exactly protection status should be established. And then more plants and bulbous cultivation was practiced, which has economical and related to drugs source. Non-food products production can be produced and entered economically. Maybe we can herbarium or other institutes about the protections, NGOs, conservation network system we can establish, and education and national strategy. If we declare it, we can, I think that we can success for the protection for the plants. Yes, I'm finished. Sorry if you overcome the time.
Thank you very much, to Professor Necmi. Now I will ask Necmi to connect from his computer again. While I am trying to prepare video for you, I will ask Mehmet Ceyhan to introduce himself and then talk about a bit from his video. And I will arrange the video, and then we will make a discuss from with Ahmet. Emre Yaprak. Thank you very much for your patience. Dear Mehmet, please, can you try?
Okay. Hi, everyone. First of all, I'm happy to meet you.
I can't hear you.
Do you hear me?
No, unfortunately.
No.
I can hear.
Do you hear me?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, okay. Hi, everyone.
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yeah,
thank you.
Hi, everyone.
First of all, I'm happy to be with you at this event. My name is Mehmet Ceyhan. I'm a director of this short documentary film. We decided to make this short movie after meeting the Professor Necmi Aksoy. And his academic career and passion inspired us.
Just a minute.
Because he's an activist. Okay, I'm meeting.
My name is Mehmet Ceyhan. I'm a director of this short documentary film. We decided to make this short movie after meeting the Professor Necmi Aksoy. I am a director of this short documentary. We decided to make a short movie.
Sorry, I think we have a problem. Can we solve now? I am trying to... did we solve the issue?
Okay.
I think we solved the issue. Is it okay now?
Yeah, I think.
Thank you. Okay. Sorry for the inconvenience. Dear Mehmet, thank you. Could you please start again?
Okay, thank you. Hi, everyone. First of all, I'm happy to meet you at this event. My name is Mehmet Ceyhan. I'm a director of this short documentary film. We decided to make this short movie after meeting the Professor Necim Aksoy. And his academic career and passion inspired us because he is an activist as well as an academician. It was also a first film made about endemic plants in this Düzce region. Therefore, we made this movie without waiting for a budget. The aim of this short documentary is to inspire and change the people's attitudes and relationship towards the environment. I hope together we can raise awareness for a sustainable environment. Thank you for listening to me. Enjoy watching.
Yolculuk olarak görüyorum. Tanıklık yapıyoruz. Ben bunu son zamanlarında öğrencilerim ve konferanslarımda da çok dikkatlice uygulamaya başladım. Özellikle bu korona döneminde bu sorguyu daha ciddi sorgulama neden oldu. Ve dünyanın en büyük yaşadığı sorun iklim değişikliği. İklim değişikliğinden önce habitat alanlarının kaybı ve kullanımlarındaki sorunlardır. Düzce bölgesinde ve yakın çevresinde tanımlamış olduğumuz endemik ve nadir bitkilerin çoğu habitatları tehdit altında. Çocukluğum Denizli Çivril Karayaşlar Köyü'nde geçti. Köyümüz Menderes'in sulamış olduğu çok güzel tarım alanlarıyla, mereler ve çayırlarla kaplıydı. 6-7 yaşlarındayken büyük babam ve babaannem beni tarlaların kenarlarında yemlik otlarıyla, ilk yenen bitkilerle tanıştırdı. Tabii bu işte kültür, coğrafya ve doğa bitki ilişkileri o zamandan beri benim çok dikkatimi çekmişti. 92 yılında ben Karadeniz Teknik Üniversitesi Orman Fakültesi Orman Mühendisliği bölümünü kazandım. Ve ben Doğu Karadeniz'in o yeşiline, o birden denizden adeta yükselen dağlarına, yemeğine, yemek kültürüne, insan çeşitliliğine çok etkilendim. Sonra akademisyen olmaya, yani botanik bilimci olmaya karar vermiştim. Çünkü hem bitkilerin sosyolojik, hem coğrafya ilişkilerin, hem de bitkilerin sınıflandırılması, taksonomik anlamda yapmak istiyordum ve ondan sonra da orman botaniğine, botanik alanın dönmesi seçtim. 1996 yılında Avanti Zeytin Üniversitesi Düzce Orman Fakültesi'nin asistan olarak Orhan Batan Emirhanı'nda başladım akademik hayatıma. Doktora eğitimime araştırma konusunu belirlerken neden bu dağlar, neden Elmacık Dağları? Bir düzce ilgili çok sistematik bir bitki toplaması yapılmamıştı. Detaylı bir proje çalışma olmadığından dolayı düzcenin bitkilerini çalışalım demiştik. Bu nedenle de en önemli güç işçilik merkezleri olan ana nokta seçildi. Efteni Gölü'nden itibaren Kardüzelesi'ne kadar bitkilerin yükseltik ve nasıl değişikliği, nasıl bir sosyolojik ilişki oluşturduklarını amacıyla Düzce Elmacık Dağı Vejetasyonu adlı doktora tezime 2001 yılında başlamış oldum. Doktora tez çalışmanın sonuçları çok ilginçti. İki tane yeni bitki türü keşfedilmişti. Yaklaşık 12-13 tane yeni bitki toplumu keşfedilmişti. Bu da bize Düzce'nin sıra dışı bir bitki ve bitki toplumu çeşitliliğini ortaya koyuyordu. İşte yaklaşık olarak %9 bir, yani her 100 bitkiden 9'un endemik olduğu bir endemizm oranını Elmacık Dağı bölgesi için ortaya çıkarmıştı. Yani aslında bir önemli bitki alanı kabul edebilecek bir yerdi. Ben de doktora sırasında buranın nasıl bir milli park olabilir, nasıl bir koruma altına alabiliriz? Daha sonra bitkilerle Düzce'ye geldiğim sırada nasıl bir işte herbaryum bitki müzesi yapabiliriz diye düşünüyordum. Biz 2009 yılında bu herbaryumu açılışını gerçekleştirdik. Herbaryum kısaca kurtulmuş bitki müzesi demektir. Dünyanın ve bulunmuş olduğu bölgenin, ülkenin değişik yerine getirmiş olan bitkilerin saklandığı, belli bir sistem düzeni içerisine verildiği, uluslararası bir akronimi olan, kodu olan müzedir, Doğa Tarih Müzesi'dir. Hatta Doğa Tarih Müzeleri'nin bir kısmıdır. Yalnızca sistematik amaçlı değil, yine etnobotanik, yine eczacılık, bitki koruma, yabancı türler gibi, dendroloji gibi kendi alanlarında çok spesifik de olsa herbaryumlar bulunmaktadır. Ülkemizde 50 kadar herbaryum bulunmaktadır. Ve uluslararası herbaryumlar dediğimiz, indeks herbaryum dediğimiz bir herbaryum listesinde her herbaryum bir akronim numarası, yani bir numarası vardır. Türkiye'nin toplam 11.700 tane bitki taksonu olduğunu yaklaşık olarak 10.000 türe ait düşündüğümüz zaman herbaryum sayısının daha çok artması ve herbaryum yanında diğer doğa tarih müzelerinin çok sayıda ya da bunlara eşdeğer olarak botanik bahçelerin, arboretumlarının çok sayıda olması gerekiyor. Son zamanlarda gerek küresel iklim değişikliği, gerek habitat kaybıları ya da gerek habitat parçalanmaları ya da doğal alanların yok olmasıyla birlikte biz çok sayıda endemik nadir bitkiler başta olmak üzere çok sayıda doğal kaynak alanımıza, doğal kaynak alanlarında yaşayan başta bitkilerimiz ya can türlerimizin yok oluşuna neden oluyoruz. En büyük problemi Düzce Peygamber Çiçeği'nde üreyimsiz çok sayıda başlıklarda tohumların oluşması. Yani popülasyon ne kadar çok parçalanırsa bitkilerin tohum tutma oranı azalıyor. O yüzden popülasyonun bütüncül şekilde korunması gerekiyor. Buradan da göle bakabiliriz ama isterseniz yani top da buradan da çekebiliriz. İşte bak buradan işte başlıyoruz. Aslında şu işte şu bu yolun genişletilmemesi lazım. Bu bazaltik kayaçlar ne olacak? Bunlar hep Batı Kadir'in horoz gözüydü. Şurası komple kazındı. Ve bitki örtüsü yok edildi. Çeşitliliğin korunması ve sürdürülebilmesi için bir tür çeşitliliğin korunduğu sistemler bütününe ihtiyaç duyulmaktadır. Düzce'de ise bu dört türün üzerine çok büyük bir problem yaşamaktayız. Bunlardan bir tanesi Efteni Gölü'nde olan Anadolu Aklar ya da Düzce Aklar Otu. İkincisi Efteni Gölü üzerinde Toptepe Güzeldere arasında bulunan Düzce Peygamber Çiçeği ya da Yaltırık Sultanbaşı. Diğeri ise Konaş Emeksiz arasında bulunan, Elmacık Dağları'nda bulunan Düzce Pelimir Otu. Bütün bunlarda yine benzer sorunlarla biz habitat kaybı yaşamaktayız. Bunun için acil koruma eylem planlarının çıkarılması gerekiyor. Küresel iklim değişikliği gibi çok büyük bir tehdit ve dünyada hızlı kalkınma modelleriyle birlikte doğa parçalanmasına gidiyoruz. Dolayısıyla aslında hiçbir noktada bizim kaybedecek bir zamanımız yok. İnsanoğlu yeryüzünün gelebileceği en son biyoçeşitliliğe tanıklık eden canlılar biz ise ve eğer iklim değişikliğiyle bir yok oluş olacaksa iyi düşünmeye ve birden bu tanıklık ve yeni bu türlerin keşfi, onun varlığı, onların devam etmesi, bütün canlıların eşit haklara sahip olması gibi birden aslında ne kadar zaman kaldı ve biz ne kadarına tanıklık edebiliriz? Bir canlının ne kadar yaşam hakkı varsa aynı şekilde doğal bir şekilde de o canlı türünün bu yeryüzünde yok oluş hakkı vardır ama doğal şartlarla. İnsan etkisiyle olmaması gerekiyor. Elmacık Dağları'nın zirvesi Kardüz Yaylası'ndayız. Ve buradaki Türkmenlerin bıraktığı izlerden bir tanesi olan balbalları görüyoruz. Bu Türkmen mezarları buranın en eski tanıkları. Buradaki yüksek dağ çayırlarının, buradaki yer endemik ve nadir bitkileri Düzce Ovası'ndan buraya çıkarlarmış. Belki de bu dağların gerçek tanıkları, bu endemik bitkilerin gerçek bekçileri onlar.
Thank you very much for your attention. Now I will give discuss Ahmet Emre Yaprak and Necmi here. And stop sharing. And after that, we will have 15 minutes and 10 minutes for Q&A and answer the questions. Thank you.
Emre ses.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. First, I would like to thank Professor Aksoy for his nice and informative presentation, and also thank to Mehmet Ceyhan for his nice documentary. And thanks again, Necmi. Just what do you think about extinction rate in Düzce area, especially, and also extinction rate of Turkish plants in overall Turkey? Just what are the main traits on them?
Dear Ahmet, it's in Düzce is a local is a for plant species is a local endemic. If includes of the other categories, not critical and endangered, and also vulnerable. It's and also included of the rare plants. Also, we call that the yellow list. It's approximately in Düzce 86, 87, I think 88 maybe. This is a has a endemic and rare plants. If mean endemic plants is 63, but four species is highly intensive risk for the treatment, and because not only human activities also, but also is a tourism activity and is a forest roads and dam projects. It's so that if adding other industrialization, tourism activities, and others, it's getting to highly risk of them. I think that the problem is just only we think about the scale of the just only whole country. I think that we must be change of the threatened category. As you know, Ahmet, you know that you can become visit of many European countries, and also you can many project. Also, you can attend of many meeting. Just only the European countries, the scale of the threatened just only city region or regional. For example, they declared of this plant is treated for these cities. For example, one of plants is exit of the natural distribution of the natural habitats in the one cities, and some bureaucratically and some people say, oh, okay, it's extinct from the Düzce city, but it's distribution from the Bolu city. So we accept their extinction. I think the
is very crowded in Turkey. Just we have 3,000 more than 3,000 endemics, and which is quite much more than many European countries' flora. So Q is very crowded. So we need to think about our priorities. Just you're right, of course. Just maybe local governments can be act like this. But of course, as a country, we have to have some priorities. For example, just only in Tuzlake area, in few decades, we lost 3 species. Just we know them; they're extinct. They are extinct. Just and endemism ratio in as you know such places, just in Tuzlake area, especially in southern Tuzlake.
So
area.
Sensitive. It's a hot spot.
It's a hot spot, and we are losing some endemics. So just as a country, we have to have some priorities. But of course, local governments can have their own priorities also. You're right.
In Düzce, you asked me ratio. I think that ratio is at the moment for the Düzce, if included critic and dangerous, I think that is more than 12 or 13 plant taxa is a threatened for the Düzce. So approximately if you focus on the 16 and 63rd endemic taxa is like 12 is all of the 5% of the total endemic taxa is getting to threatened level. So I think that we must prepare it for the country perspective conservation scale, as you told, we must be not only city, regional area, we must be habitat area, we must focus on. For example, you work on the Salt Lake Basin. Salt Lake Basin is separated from the two or three cities in Turkey. We must often focus on the totally ecosystem, and we must declare it. And I think that maybe we get update to these categories, and maybe we must establish from the new empathy for the looking to endemic and rare plants, and maybe more education and maybe more declared from the their categories for the protections, mm-hmm. More bravely against this bureaucratic system.
Thank you very much. As I know, you also study on alien invasive plants. Just in Central Anatolia, we are not affected on yeah. many native alien invasive plants because the environmental conditions are so harsh, and only plants that used to live here can survive here. But it's quite different in the Western Black Sea area, as I know. Many temperate plants can grow easily, and some alien plants can become invasive. Just could you please give us some examples and just talk about the risk about this invasive plants?
Yeah, Emre, really. So that's a so important questions. Thank you for asking. Because before we talk about the northeastern, Black Sea region is separated north and western, and also after the global warming, and it's getting from the so sensitive for the alien also and alien invasive plants. Especially, we must focus on the pathways. This is important. At the moment, in all of the boxwood tree populations, naturally, approximately is distribution from the 200 and 1,000 meters in the stream site. It's destroyed of the one of the Cladios syndicum buxifolia, one of the mushroom is destroyed. Which is this pathway? We focus on the ornamental plants industry, because our customs is there is no of the quarantine system. We must be protected of this virus and this mushroom. It shouldn't export from the abroad, especially.
By the way, there is no biologist on customs.
Yeah, just of course.
Who can identify?
Yeah, it's a big problem. Yeah. And for example, another is for northeastern Black Sea is focus on. This is Georgia boundary open, and every day more than 20,000 people is crossing the boundary of Georgia and Turkey, is because there is no visa system is easily. So I think that this is many pathways. Our research from the northeastern Black Sea, many alien invasive species such as Rus chinensis, such as Dolicera japonica, such as Microstegium bimineum, such as Tradescantia. We can at the moment, such as Opismum undulatum, we can see the under the tea plantation. Before, just on the small distribution of the sea level coastline, at the moment is getting the high altitudes. It's affected of the tea plantation because the local farmers must be clear cutting from the, as you know, there's a terrace system from the tea plantation. It must be clearing to like understory of the tea plantation for to cutting and collecting the tea shoots and leaves. And but at the moment, it's affected from the tea plantation. It's mainly, especially I would like to give the example in this gem. This is the ragweed, ambrosia. Ambrosia, high intensive, allergic, invasive species. And if you focus on...
Excuse me. The pollenologists in my department are counting ambrosia pollens in Ankara atmosphere. And yeah. as we know, there is no ambrosia in Ankara, but that and they came from the Western Black Sea area. And even the ambrosia plant in Düzce affects the allergic people in Ankara.
Yeah, of course, because you know that Düzce is like a cup shape ecological area. So it's closed. There is no high intensive is air circulations. So if many people's move to hospital as a if as an allergy, but nobody knows is a they think of not allergy. We are asthma, not asthma. This is the problem of the this species. But if local government know that? No. The municipality, gardeners, nurses know that? No, nothing about the, because at the moment the this is I think it's more problem for the all of the cities. And also maybe you know that in Mediterranean region eucalyptus and one of the opuntia. It's at the moment some invasive opuntia we opuntia macrorhiza we discovered from the Black Sea region as invasive species. It's yeah. This opuntia spinis that's right of the human lakes. If you go to walk around the this opuntia area, it's spins is affected your shoes. Is it so? I think it is, some is getting by intensively.
Thank you very much. Just I would like to ask you also. Just you are a botanist at the same time. You are a forest engineer. Yeah.
Yeah.
And what do you think about the effects of forest engineering activities in plant diversity of Turkey? Are there any side effects? Are there any malpractices?
Yeah, Emre, this is a.
It is not a yes or no question. Okay.
Yeah, Emre, is so sensitive, and this question is a. It's a conflict is in my head because why I am choose this forest engineering department because of because forest habitat is very very very very rich have a very rich forest have a rich biodiversity but the problem I think that we just only focus on the forest of the Turkey, just only woody products, and not only we think about the other source of the forest. For example, is also you know that is a medicinal plants that is the grown. I think that we must be change of the policy according to our regional biodiversity, also habitat types. I think that just only what is mean for us if you we focus on the just only timber products, especially conifer. But I think that we must change of the. So I'm happy that for the work on the Faculty of Forestry, because if you more educated the people about the biodiversity and endemic plants of the forest engineering students, I think that maybe in the future we can success for the protect for the unique and richness diversity, plant diversity area of the forest region. I think that, but it's a so conflict in my head about the, because botanists and sometimes the foresters, because also I'm sometimes conflict of the our country forestry policies heads.
Yeah, thank you very much. Just what do you think about global climate change? Just as you know, just the global climate change in geological time scale before, but in that time there were no habitat fragmentation. There were no just right now. I think just many, especially local endemics are imprisoned between artificial habitats, and whenever I see projections of the modeling studies according to climate change, just I laugh because I don't believe them, because just these plants cannot move. You told in your presentation, you told about, for example, there are some enclaves, just we can able to see some Mediterranean plants in Black Sea region, and we can able to see like Pagus orientalis plants in very southern part of Turkey. But right now it's impossible because the natural habitats are very fragmented, and they all surrounded by artificial habitats, cities, farms,
roads,
mining
dams,
roads, yeah, and so on. So just whenever I see just that kind of climate change projections, just I laugh because that plants cannot move that far.
Yeah.
What do you think about this?
Yeah, Emre, you are absolutely, you are right. Because I think that we are not ready for the meeting from the global warming. Yes. I think that we don't call that not only global warming. I think that global firing. We are firing off the world. We are firing off the ecosystem. We are firing off our cities. But nobody is thinking that this point. I think that we must be country scale, every habitat, every catchment area, or every cities. We must be getting from the monitoring system. I think that we declared out the strategies. For example, if at the moment many people, many scientists of the declared from the 1.5 centigrade degrees is rising, but if, for example, 2 or 3 years later, if for example, we see that from the 2 centigrade degrees, what is our action plans? For example, what is your action plan of the Istanbul? What is action plan of the Ankara for the this is climate crisis. If climate crisis is getting to, not only plants is migrated, also if southern region of the world, for the Middle Eastern countries, Eastern Central Asian countries, migrated of other place, and urban area is population is getting rising, and we will see the food shortage, especially wheat. And after that, we must be also, after that, some sensitive plants getting from the extinct. We must be protected from the inhabitants if we must collect it off to their seeds as a seed bank, as like a Svalbard. You know that many European countries collected the endemic plants, their seeds. I think that we must be...
There are such kind of projects, but I don't know how they really work. There are such kind of projects, but you're right. Just we have to protect them either ex situ and in situ.
Yeah. Nurdan, Emre, thank you.
Thank you very much. I think we're a bit late.
I'm grateful to be here. I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And we have some questions from Q&A. I want to read it quickly, and probably Necmi will answer, or you will answer. Let me see the questions. Thank you very much, all attendees and participants. Can you comment on Turkey's oak trees? Are any important commercially? From anonymous attendee. Yeah.
Thank you. Oak trees is Turkey is a for oak trees taxa is a endemic. One of is the Quercus vulcanica is a volcanic mountain range is distributed, and is a locally from the Taurus Mountain, is some part of Inner Anatolia, is one of endemic is a I think there is a more risk under the risk of from the Quercus archeri is a eastern western shrubland area is the coastline line. I think that this is Auxerre is a more sensitive from the about the extinction, and others is a local endemic from the just only subspecies Quercus trojana subspecies altricae. It is just only in the between Mediterranean, Taurus Mountain, in the between Mersin and Antalya region. I think this is a unique, but I think that is more local research is show that their population, because it's declared or very new subspecies. And others and others is a I think that our oak trees high intensive separated forestry lands, but I think that there is no unique ecosystem, because this all of the oak trees is a destroyed forest. I think the problem is we must be ecological restoration for the oak trees forest. For example, in Central Anatolian oak trees destroyed, and in Mediterranean or especially Eastern Anatolian, the in Iranian boundaries, Quercus branti is clear cutting for the local is created by the local people for the feed of their sheep and goats, and in the winter term, and sometimes is they using from the their timbers for the fire as a like a coal. So I think that it's mainly focus on the restorated from the oak trees habitat.
Thank you very much. I think got your answer. And next question from Nermin Aydın. What do you think about the plant endemic trans loss projects?
Maybe Emre has answered.
Translocation, maybe just she.
Yeah. Yeah, Emre, translocation just, loss. Yeah.
Yeah. Just if it is, if we know that these plants used to be there in few decades, for example, it's possible, but we don't recommend to take a plant and plant another place. Just plant need to be stay on its own habitat. But if we know about it, just according to historical data, for example, just plant used to be there in few decades ago, just we can translocate such places.
Thank you. From Yasin Bakış, I have read so much about Anatolian diagonal all around the literature. Is there a country-wide study based on specimens and statistical results that proves the existence of such thing? Thank you.
Yeah, Yasin, that's a good question. I think that we just know on mechanically know that. Just we separate it from the, according to Flora Turkey, which genus and which species of distributing the eastern side of Anatolian diagonal, and another is western side of the diagonal. I think that the problem is not we focus on the phylogenetically, not we get focus on the genetically. I think
there are very few studies, not much,
Emre.
Barış Özüdoğru published study about some Brassica cinnabars on phylogeographical situation on between western side and eastern side of the diagonal and the German scientists. I'm not sure. Just very few. There are very few phylogeographical studies, but as you say, very few.
Yeah, but we just only know that mechanically, which species, and then this ecologically know that they distributed. I think the problem, we must focus on the paleogeographically. I think that some, maybe some species from, because the Anatolian, not only Anatolian diagonal is the north side. Also we focus on the Kolchak region. We focus on the Caucasian, and then we focus on the Anatolian diagonal is the Amanus and Anti-Lebanon mountains. I think that we must focus on the global scale. And if you work on the ecological niche model, and then we included from the paleo botany, and then we comparing to also climatical changing this area, I think that the results is explaining to more than this mechanical classification.
There are many things to do.
Yeah,
of course.
Thank you for the answer. And from Naomi Miller, can goats be trained to eat specific invasive plants?
Just, I would like to answer this.
Yeah, it's a very nice question.
Very nice question. Really? I hope so. I hope so. I hope we could do something like this. But probably these goats would eat also some other plants and some endemics, maybe. I don't know. Good idea.
Naomi, that's a really, really very good question. Yes, we know that the goats also, the goats' diets is changing from the more than 400 plants, they diet, daily diets. I think that which invasive species is feeding is the really in the our phytrate not focus on the this, but really I will focus on I will read after your question. Have you got any invasive plants? Is that is easy? Feeding by goats or other animals, but I don't know.
Naomi, just we need to train policy makers first. Is it easier to train policymakers or is it easier to train goats? I don't know. Because just I can give you an example. Just Atriplex canescens is became invasive in many countries. Now government is planting Atriplex canescens in Central Anatolia. Just since I am a Canopodiaceae taxonomist, just many colleagues took pictures of these plants. Just I haven't seen this before. Just what is this? And I identify Atriplex canescens from United States, but lives in Eskişehir, Konya, Kırşehir, and so on. Yeah. So just it's better to first train policymakers.
But
stop planting such plants.
But for peoples and alien species relations, if you focus on, I would like the very good example, Naomi. This is a Robinia. This is, you know, Robinia pseudoacacia is a American trees. It's come from the Europe for a railway plantation. At the moment, beekeepers love to so much for the Robinia pseudoacacia flowers for the products from the honey. But foresters that is using the that is planted from the use of the soil erosion control. At the moment, everywhere in Turkey, every city has the Robinia. For just only, also people love to its flower. Is just many people is hanging off the indoor just from smelling a good like a perfume in the indoor perfume. So I think it's the more and some is Opuntiophicus indica. This is a Mediterranean area. Its fruits is eating the local sellers. If you go to Adana, if you go to Antalya, is that's called that Frank injury. The Frank fig, that's called that is a that Frank is foreigners meaning used to Turkey, and then is local street sellers. They prepare it from the sweet fruits and clearing to its peony, and after the some ice, and they sellers. And many people in Adana, in Antalya regions, that is these invasive plants fruits is using. And in Istanbul, some the mimosa, Acacia delbata, it's symbol of the Princess Islands. It's many peoples visited from the Acacia delbata early spring, is the end of February and start of the April. They visited from the Princess Islands for just only colorful. And in 1950s, many local peoples, maybe Christianity peoples in the inhabitants from the Princess Islands, their use of the flowers of the Acacia delbata is like a hang of the their colorful hat. So I think that's some connections, but the gods and sheeps and cows, really, I will research, maybe my new research area. You give me new subject for me. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the answers. I will read two comments and then close the session. From Naomi, for habitats that no longer exist due to urban development, archaeobotany and palynology could be helpful. In US also, it's about goat question again, poison ivy hunts the training. And then she also commented, goats are easier to train. And then one from chat, I think Gülsüm Güven, especially in Turkey, the rapid and unconscious consolidation, the brutal slaughter of nature not to be avoided, the words about the climate crisis, but the opposite of action. The seas boiling with irreversible muses, people throwing the night into nature and the seas, not even counting the city centers. Carbon emissions are too high. How can the climate crisis not be experienced? So we all human are danger for world, I guess. And last from Korhan Topçu, a short funny story. While we are driving to shoot the documentary, there was an advertisement on a local radio. It was said that an observation terrace was opened on the top of the mountain. The advertisers boosted the resort's ample parking lots and comfortable roads. And we are going to film the endemic habitat areas that were destroyed during the construction of those roads. Thank you very much for all questions, comments, and listening us. And I also thank you very much Necmi Aksoy, he is here, and Ahmet Emre Yaprak, and Mehmet Ceyhan. Thank you for your attention and understanding. Have a nice evening. Bye-bye.